So what did the Texas governor say?
He said defunding the police puts Texans in danger and invites lawlessness into our cities, and cities that endanger their residents should not be able to turn around and raise more taxes from those same Texans. He also said on Tuesday that he's all for capping property tax revenue from Texas cities that decide to cut funding from their police departments.
Terrible.
Hey, I'm Chesney Hadley.
And I'm Stephen Oduto.
And welcome to Let's Talk.
And we got a lot to talk about. Chess. Now, ever since the killing of George Floyd, I don't know if you noticed that there's been this call for defunding the police, echoing all across the 50 states. The problem is, it's a nuanced subject matter. Because a lot of people, when they hear defunding the police, they're thinking that, oh, get rid of the police, abolish the police. That's not what they're talking about. It's really about reallocating funds and putting those funds in areas where are much needed, especially marginalized communities that need funds for after-school programs, education. Basically, marginalized communities need these funds because apparently the Los Angeles LAPD, for instance, they have a total budget of about $1 billion. And so Mayor Garcetti recently announced that he's going to deduct about $150 million, which is just a small portion out of the almost a billion-dollar budget. But it's something. People just need to understand. It's a nuanced subject matter. It's not clean cut. In fact, John Lewis thought it was just a little bit too radical for him when he heard this whole notion of defunding the police. I think people just need to be more informed on the subject matter and have a little bit more understanding what defunding the police is really all about. And if you notice, the orange man, Trump, he went as far as putting out an ad out there. That is crazy because what he did is dialing 911, basically saying somebody's being raped or something to that effect. And there was no one there to answer the phone on the other side of the call. And he was trying to attach that to Joe Biden. This is what defunding the police is all about. That when you defund the police, there will be no one to answer 911. Right.
Our estimated wait time is currently 5 days.
Which is obviously
days.
A huge stretch. That's not what defunding the police is all about. Right. That's why I'm saying people need to educate themselves what this defunding the police really means.
Right. Don Lemon had to explain to Terry Crews. Mm-hmm. People get too hung up on the names. It could have been called Don't Beat Me in the Street, Cops.
Yeah.
People are too caught up in the names of it and not what the whole movement is about.
I totally agree. When you hear defunding the police, it's not about abolishing the police department.
That'd be
That's
dumb.
Not what they're talking about. Reallocating funds to certain communities. That's what they're trying to say. And that's why you even got the police unions backing Trump, because they know that if he gets reelected, he will push their agenda. He's not about defunding the police and whatnot. Stephen Odunto, signing out.
Chesney Hadley, do your research so you know what you're talking about and don't get hung up on the names of these movements.
If you like what you saw, Chesney, tell him what to do.
Subscribe, comment below, share, hit the bell notification for icon. Subscribe, like, share, comment below.
And don't forget the bell icon.
So you can get the notifications. Give us a thumbs up. Thanks for tuning in and see you later.